The question is, my weight didn't change even though you are working 3 times a week and taking the macro protein for one reason. If you're working out and taking all the nutrients, chances are your muscles are growing. Your muscles will be heavier than your fat. So the number doesn't really represent how you look, how you feel, because to look lean, to look firm, you have to have certain muscles. So important thing is to have lower your body fat. You might have lower body fat but heavier muscle, because muscles weigh more than fat.
So if you're in that position of working out 3 times a week and you're noticing that your weight's still going up, despite the fact that you feel like you're eating properly, you're having your protein, and you might be frustrated. I can almost guarantee you're probably frustrated. All of us do at some point. Here's a couple of things to keep in mind. Number one, if you're new to training, if you're new to this whole process of transforming your body, there's this period of time, whether it be 30, 60, or even 90 days sometimes, where the body has to go through an increase of muscle mass in order to help the metabolism burn body fat on a more consistent basis. And I say consistent because most people think, okay, when I'm gonna burn fat, I'm gonna burn it and I'm gonna work out to burn it. But in 24 hours a day, if you're training only to burn body fat during that 45 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour of training, then you gotta ask yourself, what happened to the rest of the 23 hours? The goal of any type of transformation is to eventually get the metabolism to hit a peak, to hit a point where after you've worked out, your metabolism should still be active throughout the rest of the day. It should still give you an advantage to have some level of fat burning, even when you're sitting at your desk, even when you're just working your 9-to-5, even if you're just lying there watching Netflix or reading a book. That doesn't happen just naturally by itself. The metabolism has to be turned on. So if you're stuck in that place of, oh man, I'm not losing weight, my weight's even going up, well then first thing you might want to ask yourself is, if the weight's going up, is it from fat or is it from muscle? If it's from fat, then it requires playing with the dietary change, because the cookie cutter version of eat healthy might not be enough for you. And that's just a common fact. Right? There's so many variables that get involved, from what's your hormone levels, to what's your vitamin intake levels, to what's your stress levels, what's your sleep levels, what's your acid versus alkaline levels in your body. There are so many factors to losing weight that in this video, there's no way that we could dissect it. But what we can do is we can help you, or in this case, I can help you by just reminding you to check those variables. Because if you know that at least your body is either gaining more fat or muscle, then that becomes the first step to going after your goal and not worrying about the weight right off the bat, okay? One of the easiest ways to do that is to go online, and this is a product that I've used, my clients use it. I do not make money off this, although I'm telling you, full transparency, I wish I did, because it's such a great tool, but you can find it online. I've got no association to it. I just really like the product. It's called the Omron weigh scale. If you go online, you're going to notice it's a weigh scale unit that has a handheld device that measures with fair accuracy. Not perfect, most of them are not, but it's very affordable and it's within range of a couple of points. It'll tell you what your body fat is, what your muscle percentage is. It'll even tell you what your visceral fat is, which is really important. So if you're really concerned, I would recommend get that weigh scale that gives you those kind of numbers. Because in all honesty, the weight itself is not enough. If you're trying to measure your fitness based on how heavy or how light you think you are, that's one piece of the equation. That's like trying to improve your car engine, but you're only looking at the oil. Well, if you only look at the oil, but not the rest of the engine, how much better can your car really improve, right? You are the car, your body is the engine. So you want to know what those numbers are, because if you are getting more muscle, good. And if you're getting more fat, obviously not good, but at least you'll know the numbers, there's no guesswork, and then you can change the training and the way you're absorbing your protein, your carbs, and your fiber, and your fats, and play with those ratios until you get that ideal weight drop while you're getting more muscle and less body fat. The second portion to this is to check how many days a week your body needs for exercise versus how much you want. In this example, we're talking about 3 days a week, right? So there's 7 days a week, someone's training 3 days a week. If they're training 3 days a week, that's a good beginner's level of training. After about a month to 2 months of consistent 3 days a week, we usually recommend kick it up to 5 to 6 days a week. Why? Because if you look at the amount of hours in 7 days, and you look at the amount of training that's involved on just 3 days, you may notice that that's not even 3% of your entire hours spent in a week. You'll need at least 2 to 3% per week of your time spent into your training. And the easiest way to do that is to spend 30 to 40 minutes a day doing your routines to make sure that your metabolism is turned on, not just on a Monday, Wednesday, Friday, but also on a Tuesday, on a Thursday, and a Saturday, and maybe even a Sunday. Give your body what it needs versus what you want, and it'll help improve your overall performance and look and the way you feel.
Remember, 50 is the new 30. If I can do it, so can you.